first grade families. I am here on behalf of all of the first grade teachers, and we just wanted to send a little message as we have about three more weeks of learning before Christmas break and we go into second semester. We just wanted to, first of all, say thank you for all you are doing at home to support your child. We know that in virtual learning, there is no way that a first grader could be successful without the help of someone at home. So we thank you to all the learning partners out there who are helping your first grader be successful. We just wanted to give you a little word of advice as we enter into the next 3 weeks. I know some of you after break will be returning to the buildings. Some of you will be right back here in virtual learning. But in order to prepare you for the third quarter, as well as to get you ready to go back to the building for some of you that are, we just wanted to share a few things with you. You will notice as you received your child's progress report that we will be doing second quarter report cards in January. And some of the standards or some of the goals, learning goals that you have seen, you see the words with increasing independence. We know that in first grade, we start off the year and we need a lot of support. Our first graders need someone to help them with a lot of reading and writing skills and some math skills. You need support from the teacher, but also from families since we're in virtual learning. But as we get closer and closer to third quarter and entering into the second semester, we like to provide some independence for first graders. It would be that way in the classroom as well. And so I just wanted to give you a few helpful hints that I would use if I were in the classroom with your child or your other teachers as well. One thing that I wanted to remind you of is that in the normal classroom, and if I were with your child, we as teachers would not be telling your child how to spell everything that they're doing in their writing. We know a lot of times we use a sentence starter, and so those words may be spelled correctly. But at this point in the year, we want to hold your child accountable to what they've learned in phonics so far. So from this point on, please do not help your child spell every single word that they write. We want them to start really being brave, and we want them to be risk takers. If they were in the normal classroom and a child asked me how to spell a word that I knew they could write down all the sounds in that word, it might not be spelled exactly correct, but they're being brave enough to try it on their own. There are words in the English language, especially those sight words, that don't follow the rules, and those are words that you may need to help your child spell. That's okay. So at this point in the year, we've learned a lot in phonics so far. And so I want you to allow your child the chance to experiment with what they've learned. Allow them to write down the sounds that they hear, and it may not be spelled exactly correct. Now, if you see that they're spelling a word and you know that they've learned that skill in phonics, then you might remind them of that skill. We're not asking you to totally not help them at all. But we would like for them to become more independent in their writing. Another tip that I had was that we want our kids, your kids, to become problem solvers. And so if there is a problem, not just in math, but in life, as they're doing their schoolwork and they're asking you questions, or they're asking you for help, we want them to become critical thinkers and problem solvers. So if there is a chance for you to allow them to make a choice and to try to solve whatever problem they have on their own, we would love for you to give them the opportunity to do that. So whatever it is, whether in math or writing or reading or science, or maybe just in your household, in life, one of the things that I always tell my kids every year. Before you ask an adult for help, unless it's an emergency, before you ask, think, how could I solve that problem on my own? Can I be a problem solver? And your child at 6 and 7 years old can start learning those problem solving skills. In the classroom, we would be doing things a little bit differently. We know that. But we're in a different world right now. We're living in the virtual world. So things are different. And we're relying on you parents to help your child by giving them support at home to help get their work done each day. And we thank you for all the support you're giving them. We don't want you to totally back off and not give them any support or any help. But we would like to see what they could do on their own. We would like to see that they can become independent. Especially those assignments that you see have a rubric attached, or maybe you see in Google Classroom that they are going to be graded, especially those quizzes, those things that you know that we are really checking to see for report cards and for progress reports. We would really love for you to allow them to do that completely on their own. Now, if it's a writing assignment and you need to provide a little bit of support, that's okay. And if you see that your child is having a lot of trouble with something, then contact your child's teacher and allow us to provide some support. But make sure that they are doing their work, not just copying either what you wrote down or tracing over what you wrote down. Make sure that they're becoming more independent. We know that they can do it. It just might take a little hard work. But something I also tell my first graders is you can do hard things. And we want to show our kids that we believe that they can do hard things. So as we go into this next quarter, we have 3 more weeks till Christmas break. I want to just encourage you that you have 3 weeks before you have another break. So just continue what you're doing at home, continue working hard, continue supporting your first grader. And we just want to thank you on the behalf of all the first grade teachers for all you are doing. Please reach out to us if you have questions or if you want to know how can I help my child without giving them the answers. We would be happy to help you with that. We thank you for all you're doing for your child. And I hope you have a great next 3 weeks of learning. We have loved being your child's teachers, and we're so excited to see all the hard work that they're going to do in the next 3 weeks and in the next semester. They are going to become more independent readers, writers, thinkers, mathematicians, scientists. I'm so impressed with all the hard work they're doing and how much they're growing. Keep up the great work.